could you tell us a little bit about the bioengineering techniques that have been used on the site?
Absolutely. One of the goals we've had from the very beginning with our first stream relocation is we wanted to make them look as natural as they would in nature and yet stabilize them because they're new and because they're not vegetated yet. So what we did on our first relocation is we were already into construction and we realized later on during construction that we needed more stream bank stabilization, and the contractor came up with the idea that he was going to bring in a lot of really heavy riprap. So that was not only going to be expensive, but that really wasn't the look that we were going for. And I remembered years ago we had started to use bio logs, and so we decided to bring them in and we used them on our first project to start stabilizing stream banks. And that's turned out to be one of our greatest tools, and we use them and they work great. What happens is over time they start to vegetate and they stay in place and they do provide the stability that we're looking for. In addition to that, we use this natural, it's like coconut weave fiber matting. And there's two reasons we really like that. It's natural, it doesn't have netting, and for little critters like little amphibians or even with any kind of snakes or birds, they don't get tangled in that like they do with some of the plastic. And so when you're in a more sensitive natural area, we always use this netting. It has a lot more give, so they don't get caught in there. And also what you can do is you can see here we use a lot of rootstock plantings in a lot of our stream bed and along the channel and sometimes a little further up depending on the degree of inundation on the channel. But what we do is we cut holes in this matting and we put the rootstock in there. And what happens then is that when the rootstock starts to expand, the matting gives. And so it isn't like some of the other tighter mattings where it will actually constrict the rootstock so it can't just start to expand like we want it to. And in addition to that, we have what we call our rootstock protection. We learned the hard way, I think, on one project that I replanted twice because we had planted the rootstock and then the geese showed up. And what they do is pull it out, they eat the little tubers, and all of a sudden the rootstock was all floating in the water. So we planted it again, next time went back, floating in the water. So we decided we were gonna have to figure something out to keep the geese from eating the rootstock before it gets rooted and established. And so I had gone to a workshop years ago and they had talked about potential staking. And this is actually another item that DOT uses on any project where we have rootstock. And you have the spacing of the stakes, and what's critical to these is that not only that the stakes be set out where the geese can't reach in and grab the rootstock, but you also have it on the back side so that once the silt fencing would be down, they can't also grab it from the other end. And you need these three layers of twine. The reason you really need that is so the goslings can't go under, the goslings go under, the parents follow. And then you also need the additional two heights. And so, like I said, what we always try to do is incorporate as many natural biotech projects, products as we can, and to keep it more natural and very critter friendly, which is one of my top priorities on any project. So.
How does the maintenance work for a project like this too? You have to come back so often and check things? Like, you know, everything that's in place now, somebody watches it and makes sure that things stay in place?
Well, if we get wetland mitigation credits, and anytime we have wetland mitigation credits, we have to come out and monitor any of our wetlands. And so we do that for a period of 5 years. So long after the contractor and everybody's gone, I'm still out here every year doing vegetative monitoring, doing maintenance or management of invasive species, and just checking on how everything is going.